in terms of actual solution, so prolotherapy is generally, it's a dextrose solution. There's some docs out there who will call, they'll say PRP, prolotherapy, or stem cell prolotherapy, because at the end of the day, prolotherapy just stands for proliferative therapy. But when I talk about prolotherapy, it's in relation to dextrose prolotherapy. So it's a sugar. We inject that into the same areas that we would if we were using PRP. That dextrose does a few things. One, it can calm down some of the pain that's coming from nerves. And two, it also stimulates fibroblasts, which are the cells within our tendons, ligaments, that produce collagen. So basically, we get some increased collagen production from the fibroblasts. Comparing that with PRP, PRP is we take your blood, spin it down, we basically concentrate the platelets that are found within your blood. Those platelets normally in our body are responsible for healing things that are broken. So for example, if you break a blood vessel, platelets are the first thing to, one of the first things to respond to that damage. They release growth factors from within them that help with the healing process. So when we inject the platelets into an area of damage or degeneration, we're basically helping to re-kickstart a new healing response, and it's a stronger response than what we see with the dextrose prolotherapy. The dextrose is basically just an irritant to the fibroblasts, and that results in them making collagen because they go, holy cow, there's stress in this area, so I need to strengthen this area. Whereas the PRP, I think of it more as the platelets go, there's damage here. Let's try to orchestrate and help repair this damage. Depending on the structure we're injecting, sometimes we, when we do PRP, we add in prolotherapy with it because it's more, I believe that there's a dual effect when we do that, and they're synergistic. And tendons is going to be one of those if we're injecting like where the tendons attach, which it sounds like in your case, we more than likely would on the patella and actually on the tibia. Then with that is it's a strength difference. And so on average, we see that one PRP treatment is usually equal to about 2 to 3 prolotherapy treatments. So most patients who come in from out of state end up going with PRP primarily, sometimes stem, but usually PRP. And the reason for that is if it can reduce the number of trips somebody has to take out here, you know, even in half, then financially it makes more sense to do PRP versus prolotherapy. But you're not missing out if you do PRP over prolotherapy.
Yeah,